Hold on to me as we go. As we roll.
One of the pillars of redesign that we've really engaged with this year is flexible learning environments. For us, it was very important to look at ways to give our learners opportunities to have more choice and voice in how and when they learn, and to give them a really authentic voice at the table in making educational decisions. Engaging into flexible learning environments and initiating our flex block truly has been a journey for the whole community. We looked at our very traditional timetable and we thought, how can we leverage more time in the day? So at the high school, what we did is we took 87-minute blocks and we shaved 7 minutes off of each of those. That leveraged 28 extra minutes in the day. We had to make the shift, though, a paradigm shift from instructional time to learning time, and assure the teachers that that time was significant in granting students access to instructional opportunities and creative ways to engage them and to deepen learning experiences.
I think for flex, usually at our school at senior high, we have a longer lunch break, so we have an hour long lunch break. And during that time, we are able to, usually teachers host like different sessions like extra homework help, or they schedule a lab during that time, or just another fun activity to help support the lessons that we're learning during class.
Était levé. Donc, s'il vous plaît, une personne qui parle, qu'est-ce que c'est? Savi.
Also during that time, usually aside from the academic stuff, we also have like, for student council, we have a lot of lunchtime events that we run during flex time, and now that it's longer, we can plan like different events than we would have had if we only had 45 minutes. Also during that time, usually a lot of rehearsals if you're in arts or sports, that's usually during flex time, that's when we do our rehearsals. So for me, like I'm in dance, so a lot of our dance rehearsals for recitals and concerts and stuff like that we do during flex.
This is the first year that we are running flex. We actually started the year not offering flex block, and then slowly implemented the flex block to the point where at exam break or semester break, we had a staff meeting to determine whether we wanted to continue, and the staff decided that we wanted to maintain that the time during the day. Before really encountering flex, I didn't really know much about it. I mean, I read the Inspiring Education document. Last year, we ran a two-week trial period in the last few weeks of May to just kind of sample out flex and get a feel for it. And so a lot of the staff, including myself, were kind of unsure as what it was going to look like. But I think that's the beauty of flex in the sense that it's individualized for every school. So after we got started with flex, I got really excited about it and started creating, you know, these different types of opportunities for my students that they wouldn't get on a regular classroom basis. One of the most significant opportunity that I started was actually started by one of my students who asked about the Ukraine crisis, the conflict in Ukraine. And we actually have a staff member here whose friend is doing her a doctorate in Ukraine, and so we Skyped her for 45 minutes over flex, and she spoke Polish and he spoke Polish, so the students had to talk to him in English and then he would translate for her and she would translate back, and it was awesome.
Part of the Inspiring Education mandate, I think that the flex program that we've incorporated in the school is one of the most important aspects to this point. As science teachers, and specifically in physics, requires a lot of experimental work with very expensive equipment that you cannot buy too many sets. Students have to be able to work in little groups to try to share the equipment. The incorporation of a flex program now gives the students a chance to come at lunchtime during their flex program and do the experiment slowly, the way they want to do it, explore a little bit deeper and with a little bit more understanding. This extra time would not have been possible with the regular program. Before, we had to rush students through the labs, and not all students had the benefit of operating the equipment.
Like, flex time has helped me discover my strengths, especially with physics and that, like, because I'm going to the U of A for astrophysics, and doing the extra physics labs at lunch, it really kind of helped concrete that idea in my mind. And also, I just really enjoyed doing physics labs and that, so it was a lot more fun.
So the students like it in that aspect. They all go there and they'll come back at lunchtime and they'll say, I finally saw it, or I finally did it, which is as a science teacher, this is what you want the kids to explore and to discover.